So what is the SIEM? So there are many types of detection analytics that can be implemented with network data. Signature-based, like an IDS or antivirus, rules-based, frequency-based, behavioral-based. So originally, a security information and event management, or SIEM platform, some call it SIEM, I don't know why, was called a correlation engine. It performs rule-based alerting that historically was not using the mathematical definition of correlation. It was more about comparison. So for example, if an EDR agent stops three attempts in a row, meaning number four was probably successful, then the asset is communicating with a foreign country, then it's seen scanning the network for open SMB shares or firing up Mimikatz, which is a tool for recovering passwords from network traffic. That's three strikes, and the asset goes to the top of the investigation priority list. But not anymore. Modern, mature SIEM products use machine learning to ingest large language models and identify indicators of compromise that are very subtle and aligned with the MITRE ATT&CK framework so that we know it's in the reconnaissance phase, it's in the delivery phase, exploitation, command and control, et cetera. One of the drawbacks of a SIEM platform is the management it takes to constantly refine and add the detection rules. So many come pre-installed, but tuning down false positives and adding detections for new tactics does take significant management. Sometimes the co-managed model for SIEM operation is the best fit for organizations. Take advantage of these types of devices, use a managed service. So today, think of a SIEM as a highly capable alerting source on your network. An intrusion detection system is also an alerting source, but signature-based detection is very 20th century at this point.